Not a single petal is fallen. Okay, all petals are here. Where is the flower? But you said petal, flower is made up of petal. Where is the flower?
Petals arranged in a pattern.
Petals arranged in a form, pattern called flower. Petals arranged in a form, a given name is called flower, right? There are two aspects, a form and a flower. Form and a name. The form is called, there is a form, and the moment form goes, there is no more flower. The name is already, we told, it's just a label. So you can flower the karibu, who want karibu, you can call it any name. It's just a labeling mechanism. Okay. So now I have removed all the petals. So the flower you say is made up of petals, which is not flower. Do you agree or anybody disagrees here?
Petals is not flower.
Petals is not flower. But all three of the petals also is no flower. Okay. So now petal itself you take. What is it? Again, atoms, molecules. So what are the colors of flower?
Non-flower.
The whole.
Whole non-flower you are calling this flower. If you go deeper and deeper, the petal, the flower is flower. Flower is not the flower is made up of petals. You have to go to substance. Substance is flower, petal. Substance of petal is atoms, molecules, which is recognized by consciousness. So what is the real substance?
So, you tend to stop there. So, I don't experience atoms, subatoms.
No. So, right now, this atom and subatom is a concept. That's why I said it's a concept.
Correct. So,
but
you see
so the moment I say, the moment I say,
no.
There's no experience. This moment I say concept, you understand what is a concept?
Yeah, concept.
Understanding is sufficient. We cannot visualize it. And no scientist also visualize actually. They say there's a probability theory. So, at some point of time, perception stops and conception starts. Okay? But still, ultimately it has to go to consciousness. Without consciousness, is there a conception possible?
And we'll have to explain consciousness. Actually, there will be different perceptions of consciousness.
Consciousness is knowing ability.
Knowing?
Ability to know, let's say.
Of what?
Of anything. I know this. There is something. I know there is something. The knowing ability, I am telling you. The knowledge is object. Knowing ability, I am saying consciousness at this moment. So it stops at knowing. Beyond the knowing, you can't go. Unknowing, you can't go. So ultimately we go to anything you take, the real substance we take to the consciousness. Do you agree or not? Anybody disagrees, please? Yes.
So ultimately you're saying everything is a concept and concept is consciousness.
Okay. So the logic you understand. Everything is a name and form. The form is the form real? Let me ask the question now. So actually, what we are saying is, everything is a name and form. Now the flower is a series of name and forms actually, it's not one name and form. The flower word is pointing to fabric is pointing to yarn is pointing to atoms, which is pointing to consciousness, which is pointing to subatomic particles, which is pointing to consciousness. So it's a series of multi-directional pointers, multiple pointers. This is like typically we ask the addresser, sir, I want to go to this thing, what is it? Ashoka pillar. Ask somebody. Simple, sir. Go take a right turn, go take a left turn, go to take left turn, right turn, there's you see a small shop, take a right turn, go there. So none of them is Ashoka pillar, all directions. So everything is every point is a direction. Finally, it's the final direction is consciousness.
But then the mind asks, so what? Okay. The concept is fine. Then So what do I do with
that? No, you don't do anything. So what you are trying to understand is that word is never a reality. The meaning of the word is reality. The meaning of the word is reality. It moves from grosser to subtle to subtle and finally reaches consciousness. The subtlest is the reality, not the grossest. Right? The reality is grossest, not the subtlest. I mean simple, let's understand very simple way, right? Somebody says, I love you and brings a diamond ring. Diamond ring is gross, but I love you is subtle. By looking at the way you have given diamond ring, you know whether it's what's happening inside, right? Subtle is important, not the final. take the remedy. I love you. I love you. What is the difference? Is the gross or subtle which makes difference?
Subtle.
Subtle. Everything in the physical in the world ultimately becomes subtle, and the subtlest is called paramarthic reality. And that's the only reality. Everything else is a pointer. And pointer is not an object also. Pointer is just a name.
In the short term, the subtle makes meaning, but in the long term, the gross makes meaning.
No. Gross makes a meaning in the Vyavaharika. The three levels of reality I told you. Okay? Three levels of reality I told you. Paramarthika, Pratibhasika, and Vyavaharika. For somebody who is dealing with the word Vyavaharika reality only, you can't use Paramarthika reality. Okay? Like if you go to America, you have to drive on the right-hand side of the road. You can't, no, India left-hand side of the road is there, no, it doesn't work. So in your transaction, you have to use transaction level, it's a flower only. So it doesn't become the consciousness. But then you sit for meditation, from flower you have to move to consciousness. Then you'll find the peace. If you get stuck to the flower, so, for transaction purpose, it's a flower.
Does it make you more peaceful once it dawns on you that is...
Absolutely. I'll tell you how.
Yeah,
okay? How it's important, I'll tell you. Okay? So, at the physical level, flower is a flower. But when you sit for meditation, we don't get stuck to flower. We move from grosser to subtle to subtle, subtle to subtle, subtlest we go, it's consciousness. Okay? If you don't go to subtlest to consciousness, you will never find peace. You get stuck at the lower level, don't find peace. Yes,
sir. Prabhu, the word mind. Prabhu, it's an absolute reality.
No, mind is just a thought. Okay?
Not so, an object.
Mind is an object. See, for example, paramarthika level of reality, the definition is, it doesn't change. The mind changes, sir. Every moment it changes. So, that mind belongs to the category of pratibhasic reality. So in meditation, we have to go to paramarthika reality. We should not get too stuck to vyavaharika or pratibhasika. This is the mistake which happens in meditation. That's why you don't reach the peace. You get a temporary peace, you don't get the absolute peace.
Did you mention that you don't need to do all the different types of yoga to go directly?
It is not yoga. No? I'm just making you understand. It's understanding.
Yeah, right.
There's nothing.
The meditation piece is still some via.
No, that's what I mean. You need to do that to maturity level to listen this talk. So this talk, admission criteria.
entry criteria.
Those who have tried all those things is the entry criteria. This is only for mature people who have understood this is what is the limitation of this. Now, how do I go beyond that limitation? I'm pointing out where you are stuck in that limitation.
All those are
preparatory exams.
Pre-pre-pre.
Right? So, people have to go to some yoga, people have to go to some kriya, before they can understand, this doesn't give me final peace. I am stuck somewhere. So now, where you are stuck, I am pointing out. Are you getting, madam? Anybody has a question? Yes, sir.
So, my question is a rather complex question.
Tell me.
Does spirituality exist, per se, for only humans?
See, I don't even ask, that question is not...
What is the question?
No.
Does spirituality exist in general only for humans?
So, this question of spirituality is again a word, sir. Right? We said world is not a reality. Clear? The meaning of the world is reality. Clear? Agreed or not? Now the question, his question is, does spirituality only for human beings or is it for animals also? Now, let us go on to the meaning of spirituality rather than get stuck with the word called spirituality. Right? What is the meaning of spirituality?
If I have to answer it, it is my question. So spirituality in general, if you say it's a concept. So concept can be, so for an ant, the spiritual realm can
no,
be.
No.
Just,
let us not get into ant term. The spirituality definition we started with today is finding peace. Right? My definition of spirituality for this discussion is peace. Maybe love. So now, is peace and love universal or only human beings?
It depends on the definition of peace. Depends on how we...
Let us say you torture a dog. Let us say you have a pet called dog. Torture, does it like it? every living being doesn't want to be tortured, right? Every living being wants to live. Okay? Desire for life is common to all these beings. Anger, thirst. Okay? And everybody wants to go to sleep also. The sleep is what peace people can find. If you disturb the sleep of a person, he'll become mad. So sleep is unconscious peace. So conscious peace is something we are searching for. This peace is called spirituality. And desire for peace, at least in the form of sleep, is common for all the living beings. Only human beings can find a consciously peace, whereas animals cannot. They can find an unconsciously peace. That's all the definition. See, there is no spiritual seeker and materialist. There's nobody. There's only spiritual seeker for me. Because a person who is selling tea, okay, struggling 12 hours a day, what is he doing for? Earning some money, survival. If I become survival, I'll be happy, I'll be peaceful. Earning tea is a means, but reality he is, at least one day's peace is searching for, no? See, this whole concept of spirituality and all, it's become the words, buzzwords. Spirituality is peace, everybody is looking for peace. Only thing is, many people don't know what exactly find to peace directly. So that way they go through a lot of struggle in life how to find peace. Peace you can find directly only when you go to the truth. And I am telling you what is true, what is reality. So that's the only way which you can go to truth. That's what our ancestors have told. Satyam. And I am telling you what is Satyam. Okay? So any object in the world is nothing but consciousness. Points to consciousness. That substance is consciousness. The form is something. Agreed? So now is form reality? No, form is real, you'll say. The name is words, mere words, pointers. Is the form reality? Is it real, sir, form?
Vyavaharika.
Is it real? Suppose somebody doesn't have a, somebody eyesight has a problem. For him, the color blindness is there. The colors he can't see at all in the world. Agreed? So for them, color is unreal for him. His world has no word meaning, nothing called color. Agreed? So that means the form depends on your sense organs. Right? So form is a dependent reality on sense organs. Agreed? It's not independent reality. That means nothing called form. It's only dependent on your eyes. If your eyes are sharp, I mean, let's say tomorrow you go home and sleep and get up in the morning and you get an X-ray vision. Superman. Then if you see bottle, what do you see? If you have X-ray vision, sir, what do you see in the bottle? Bottle is not there, only metal will stop. So it depends, the world that we experience form is nothing but sense organs. Right? So the form is not absolutely paramount, it depends on the sense organs. Agreed? So it's a relative reality. So now sense organs are dependent on the mind. The eyes are working, but my mind is somewhere. Can't see. So the mind is working, the person is unconscious. The consciousness is the reality. So finally, take the form, you'll go to consciousness, the reality. Take the name, you'll come to the consciousness, reality. Ultimately, all pointers are pointing to only one reality called consciousness. Agreed or disagreed? Right? And that consciousness is called God or Brahman in Indian philosophical system. Okay? Now we'll say, so what? Consciousness is Brahman. What has to do with me? Why should I worry about consciousness? Just say, yeah, it's okay, great. The good news is, you are that consciousness. The bad news is, you don't know that you are consciousness. So good news is, you are consciousness. The bad news is, you don't know your consciousness. You think you are a body, you think you are a man, you think you are a woman, like just like you thought this is a kurta. So we live in a transactional reality without understanding the absolute reality. Are you getting what I'm saying? So unless you understand absolute reality, you'll never get a peace. Because you are always going in a transactional reality which is constantly changing. Tell me, sir, this model of kurta is available next year? This kurta will become old. The transactional reality will keep on changing. And if you keep on changing, how can you have peace? You have to change something which doesn't change, which is absolute, which is real. That is called consciousness. Are you clear? So, the entire spiritual teaching in India is only one thing. It's three words. You are that. Tat Tvam Asi. Tat Tvam Asi means you are that. What is that?
Consciousness
which doesn't change. Who is you? I know, sir, I'm an engineer. IT engineer. 15 years experience and management consultancy. There are transactions required, what a paro. For your survival, you need to do something. Udara nimittam bahukrata vesham. For survival, you have to do a lot of style. But that's nothing to do with reality, absolute reality. Absolute reality is you are consciousness. So what? The consciousness is reality, consciousness is peace. I don't know, I never find peace. I found only peace with my wife when she doesn't talk. Because your mind is always set on the transactional reality. Your attention has to move to absolute reality. So that is what is spiritual journey, entire spiritual journey. Shifting the attention from the transactional reality to pratibhasic reality to absolute reality. Then you will find peace. You have to look for peace where it's there, in the absolute, not in the relative. That is the teaching of Vedanta. That the word. So there may be so many scriptures, this scripture, that scripture, that scripture. But only three words are pointed out by that. Tattvamasi. Description of that is so many scriptures. Don't get misled by so many. All descriptions are mere words. Even don't get misled by a word called Tattvamasi. Go to the meaning of Tattvamasi. Understand the essential meaning of Tattvamasi. Leave out Vyavaharika and Pratibhasika. Go to the essential meaning of Tattvamasi. That's called consciousness. Now, show me consciousness. I can't show you consciousness because you are consciousness. I can show me. Now I'll tell you, get me some space. Sir, give me some space. Give me some space, sir. How do you give space? Space is all around. You cannot give what is already all around. Like that, consciousness is all around. Every object is consciousness. Everything is consciousness. You cannot give that because everything is pointing to consciousness. That's why God or Brahman is all pervading reality.
But most of the world lives in transactional reality and you want the other people to realize that.
No. Who
be? They will continue. No, not you.
No. Please understand. Please understand.
You want other people to realize that. They need to see...
Please understand. The spirituality is not for changing the world.
Yeah.
For changing the world, management consultants are. For changing world, CEOs are there. Businessmen are there. Abba, I want to get peace. I don't want to. Even changing your wife also is not possible. Please forget.
Yeah.
Forget it. So spirituality is for me to become peaceful, not for teaching anybody anything. And this teaching you cannot go and teach somebody else also.
Yeah.
They have to come to a master because there's a certain logic and pattern and process involved, like a surgery. Okay. So that is spirituality is for only for your peace. You cannot give peace, you can give some happiness to somebody out of that peace. You can share happiness. Peace cannot be shared. Because peace is absence of disturbance. That's where it started. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, yes sir. Okay. How am I on time? Yeah, I mean how much more you want me to continue? How close?
10 more minutes.
Sorry.
I have one question. Spirituality is absence of disturbance, peace and all that.
Yeah.
But is all these words I mean, are there kind of peace, ecstasy, bliss, all these are same?
No, no, they are not same. They are not same. Okay? There's a difference between that. Peace, ecstasy, love, they are all same, different. They are, one is root and others are derivatives. I'll tell you what.
On similar lines, the realization and like the that can be explained.
That is 2 day session. Because you need to get it. See, these are all very subtle.
Yeah.
If I give some gross definition.
What is his question?
Now his question is, realization and enlightenment are the same. I said it takes time for us to understand terminology. Right now I brought you to just to make the understand the shirt is not shirt. So now how do you make understand realization is not realization?
Can I simply answer? He said you are consciousness.
Sorry?
He said you are consciousness.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that?
Are you
able to accept it conceptually?
Yeah, when you...
Yes or no?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes, yes.
Can you live in that acceptance level 24/7?
Difficult.
That's because you have to realize that.
Yes.
As simple as that. So yeah, if you can get to the 24/7, living at that level, that is realization. And since you are talking about your own self,
right,
which is consciousness, it can be simply termed self-realization. Simple way to understand. It's a lifelong journey.
No, the problem is coming because various people are giving various definitions, various building some auras around that. So the confusion comes, so is this right, is this right? For example, his question is ecstasy, love and peace, are they one and the same?
Yes.
Okay, similarly spirituality, that exactly as you said, peace, find yourself and be peaceful. That is spirituality. Now various people give you something, some definition, right? But then don't get attracted, carried by that. Ultimately, we go to peace, self. So the world called peace, shanti, okay, and love and ecstasy, they are different expressions. When the mind is completely silent, there is no thought, no agitation in the mind. The mind is one with the self, that's called peace. There's no movement in the mind. There's total stillness. Okay, that is called peace because there is no disturbance, there is no movement. Okay, the moment you say I was peaceful, already disturbance has started. The mind is expressing itself. I was peaceful, to express that mind has to move. Say I was peaceful. The peace is total silence. The moment you open your mouth, peace is... you have to come out of this. One. Second thing, when you start going to the peace again and again, you start becoming more and more mind, because more and root of the mind start becoming more and more peaceful when interacting with the world. So when you are peaceful, okay, you feel more connected to the people. When you are agitated, you feel disturbed. Somebody is depressed, it sits on someone's side, it doesn't get connected. So when you are peaceful, you feel lot of connectivity with plants, animals, living beings, non-living beings. That's called love, prema. That's also called bhakti in higher level. The ecstasy is, there is energy movement in the body. Okay? Suddenly there's some energy movements happens in the body. Like for example, somebody is singing devotional bhajans. You start crying. Now why you are crying? The energy movement is happening. The energy movement happens out of love. Okay? But love came out of peace. That's why peace is the root. So now, everybody has not got the peace, but they still love the cry when the love is happening, when they sing bhajans. That's only love at the mental level. They have not touched the love of the deeper love. The deeper love is called parabhakti, the mental level is called aparabhakti. So you have touched only the tip of the iceberg. So if you go deeper, there's tremendous energy movement, that's called ecstasy. So peace is the root, love and ecstasy are the shoots. Somebody who has a peace may not have ecstasy. For example, Ramana Maharshi is sitting silently, there is no ecstasy. But somebody else may have some ecstasy because he knows the energy movement. So it doesn't mean that peace is fundamental. Love and ecstasy are expressions which are coming out of the fundamental. Are you clear?
Bliss is also...
The bliss is actually, the bliss, the word bliss in English is coming from the word called ananda in Sanskrit. Okay, the Ananda word translate as bliss, and every soul has bliss nowadays, right? So bliss is a marketable commodity. The bliss is not marketable commodity. When your mind is silent, totally silent, one with the self, there's no agitation there. When there's no agitation, there's infinity. Finite will come only when there's agitation, movement. So that infinity, feeling of infinity, is called Ananta, infinite. That expression of Ananta, infinite, is called Ananda. So Ananda, peace and bliss are synonymous. Okay? Even though English word bliss doesn't mean Ananda. Okay? Ananda is the infinite expansion. It's not really expansion because your mind is not moving. In total stillness, the experience, whatever the experience is called Ananda, infinity. That's called bliss. That's called peace. The derivative of that is called love and ecstasy.
Sat-chit-ananda.
We'll come to that. Okay? Next is that. So is that much clear now? The logic is clear. Everything in the world is pointing to consciousness. But you start chasing the word instead of the meaning of the word. That's why mind gets thoughts. Why I'm sitting for meditation? Thoughts are coming. Because you are going behind the word, not the essence of the word, which is meaning, which is consciousness. You are after the transactional, after the paramarthika and vyavaharika. You are not going to the paramarthika. You have to go back to consciousness, then the mind will become still. Okay? So now how do I go to the mind? That's why the teaching is called Tattvamasi. You are that. Now what are you, sir? So I am saying you are that. Okay, what are you? What is your description of you?
I was to describe myself. You could say I am nothing at the same time I am something.
Huh. So when I say use the word I a million times a day, I am using a word. Understand? The word is not the meaning. The meaning of I is you. Word is never the meaning. Just now I proved, shirt. The meaning of I is you. And the meaning of I can be only one, which is called consciousness, which is you. But unconsciously you say, associate that I with the body, which is transactional, mental, vyavaha, pratibhasika. But you don't associate with the paramarthika, but every time when you use the word, you are actually using it in the reference to paramarthika, absolute. But you are confusing with the vyavaharika. Vyavaharika is vyavaharika. Okay? No need to confuse. Vyavaharika is vyavaharika. When you talk to somebody, you are what you are. I am engineer. But that's vyavaharika. But you should be aware that this is vyavaharika. But the absolute meaning of that is I means consciousness, paramarthika, that you should know. You can't tell tomorrow. In your visiting card, you can't change it. CEO of somebody, no, I am consciousness of some company. No, you can't change that. That paramarthika will not work in the vyavaharika. Okay? But for your peace, you need to know. Right? So let us ask the question. Right? Sir, can you tell me somebody who lived in other cities? Can you please raise your hand? Some other city, different city. Other than Bangalore. Which city, sir, you lived?
Madurai, Chennai.
So you lived in Madurai. How many years back?
38 years back.
So 38 years back, he lived in Chennai. Okay? So now he lived in Chennai. Is it a word or a meaning? He lived in Chennai. Is a word or a meaning? All the three words. He lived in Chennai. What is the meaning? We'll try to find out. The word is clear. He lived in Chennai. It's English word. The word is clear. So now let's find the meaning. Sir, when you lived 38 years back in Chennai, how what is the shape of your body? How young you are? Sir, he was like this. So, are you clear? When he lived 30 years back, he was like this. Now he is like this. Okay. Your mind, mental state, how was it, sir? Chennai, the 38 years back and now? Is it same or change?
Change.
So mind has changed. The body has changed. intellect, sir. You learned so many things earlier, later. So intellect has changed. So body has changed, mind has changed, intellect changed. So are there pranamartika or vyavaharika? What is changing is what? Huh? Vyavaharika. But he says, I live in Chennai. The I has not changed. So what he is doing, he is using vyavaharika. The word is I is pointing to vyavaharika, paramarthika, but he is using it for transaction purpose and saying, I am the body. Are you getting the logic? The reality of I, meaning I, is something which is not changing. 38 years not changed, now it is not changed. Body keeps changing, the mind keeps changing, intellect keeps changing, but something in you has not changed, no? That's why you say I. Agreed? So the unchanging I in me is paramarthika reality. Now tell me, which textbook you will find out I, the meaning of I? I is your inner experience. I cannot prove that, I cannot disprove that you don't exist in Chennai. You say, I only existed. You say, I only am there now. Are you sir, your body has changed? No, I only is there. No, your mind has changed? No, I was there. So which I, who was there in Chennai? You understand the difference between word and meaning? So who was there in Chennai? Tell me. Consciousness was in Chennai, consciousness is there now. Yes. Consciousness there will be tomorrow. The body, mind, intellect is just changing, it's vyavaharika reality. So now, if you start thinking that I am body, then you are gone case, you are holding on to unreality, which is changing. Are you getting, sir? Agreed?
Yeah.
I'll give you a small story which I repeat many times. I went to a house in Malaysia, okay? A rented house. The landlady was living in the ground floor. Okay? So my other tenant had given the key to that lady and he has left to ask me to collect the key from that lady. I went to that lady. A old woman came, must be 75 plus. Aji, key kodi, grandma, give me the key. The moment I said, she started shouting at me. She burst. How dare you call me grandma? How dare you call me Gaji? Everybody in the street calls me auntie. Okay? You are calling me Aji first time. This is the last time. If you tell me, call me Aji or grandma next time, I will throw you out of the house. Why did she get angry? Huh? What is that? She is associating the transaction reality, which is body.
Yes.
But the I has not changed, nothing has happened. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, madam, you look very nice. You feel happy. Does I look nice? I never changes. Okay? Somebody says, oh, you look nice. Somebody says, hey, how do you look? So the transactional reality can be used to manipulate you like left and right center. And our corporate guys are know very well.
Carrot and
stick. Such a brilliant guy, certificate on the Monday morning and pink slip in the Friday evening. So transactional reality can be manipulated, but paramarthika absolute reality cannot be manipulated. That's what you are. Why are you getting it manipulated? Why are you getting into a remote control and manipulation by the world when you are the absolute reality called I, which is nothing but self, which is nothing but consciousness? How can you get agitated? You are getting agitated because moment to moment you are confusing yourself with the transactional reality, not with the absolute reality which you are. And do I have to prove you that your I has not changed? Sir, I have to tell you that in 30 years back you are only there. You know it. I was there. I am there. The I is not changed. The scriptures are not telling you something which you don't know. So scriptures are pointing out to you what you know, but you ignore. That's Vedanta. It doesn't say believe that there's an I. Your I is reality. So the difference is the scriptures are pointing out to you what you already know unconsciously, but you have forgotten because of transactional and vyavaharika reality. So that's what is confusing. Now the confusion is only getting clear, nothing else. So there is a method of clearing this confusion. It's not like a come to this thing, repeat million times, aham brahmasmi, aham brahmasmi, aham brahmasmi, repeat it. No. There is a very, very precise, logical, clarifying process that's called Atma Vichara. It's not a random process. It's a very systematic step-by-step process to make you understand the reality. And that is called Atma Vichara. That is the Vedanta teaching. It's not just like listen to scriptures, hours, millions of hours, listen. No. That stuffing yourself, that comes out of Jnana Yoga. Atma Vichara is getting to the point. What the hell, what is the real meaning of the essence of teachings? By dropping ignorance. So sir, okay. Now, he says 38 years back, he was in Chennai. Why were you in 38 days back?
Mumbai.
So he was in Mumbai. Who was in Mumbai?
I was in Mumbai.
Who is in I? Same body?
Yes.
Huh? Body the same?
Body same.
Oh, I mean, you're...
It has changed.
So?
But same
body. So, I has changed?
Yeah.
Huh? I has changed or I has not changed?
Changed. Huh? I has not changed.
Huh. So then who was there in Chennai? The body has changed now. The mind has changed. Intellect, everything in the package has changed. Still you say the same package is there? See, body, mind, intellect is constantly changing package. Okay? There's unchanging in I in me and changing package in me. Always when I speak of I, always I speak of unchanging I, which is paramarthika. And always I confuse with the changing. Right? So moment to moment if you are clarifying this, you'll never confusion will stop. Then moment to moment you clarify this, so then you start becoming peaceful in your transaction also.
So I have a question.
Yes.
So what we are saying is that it is necessary for you to come out of that unreal world in order to know the reality.
No. We are sitting here only. We are not going to any other world.
I mean,
so your question is you have to go to some other world.
Yeah.
No. See.
No, what I'm saying is
nothing to do with vyavahar. See, this is again corruption in spirituality.
Hmm.
So stop doing vyavahar, go to some ashram, go to some Himalayas. So there's nothing to do with that. So there's nothing to do with spirituality. The real spirituality is the clarity in understanding Vedantic teachings through an authentic master and authentic source. So the moment you get a clarity, so you understand the reality, then you put it in your practice, your day-to-day living, vyavaharic life, understand what is reality, but do the transaction.
Okay, that's a question
okay.
I was wondering.
You don't have to go anywhere, because I cannot go anywhere. I is everywhere.
So operate from the other end.
No, vyavaharic you do, vyavahar only. But you deep inside you know
yeah.
I. Okay? Of course you can do some meditation and contemplation to go back to I. That's called nididhyasa, that's a different term. Okay, otherwise right now, you don't have to leave anything because nothing can be left. Okay, now the point I'm coming was, you are there in 38 back in Chennai, Bombay, he was in Chennai, I was there. So now this I and this I is different or the same? There are two I's now. One I and another I. And another I. How 38 years back, where are you?
Bombay.
So that I was in Bombay. So how many I's are there in this room?
Seven.
Huh?
They are same.
Only one eye is there operating through many packages called body mind. So when you refer eye, you are actually referring to absolute eye, but always you are confused with transactional eye. Vyavarika. Got it? So the confused eyes are many, but real eye is only one. And that one eye, which is universal, a person in America, Africa, England, London, animal, who is that I, is only one. That's why it's called God. That's why it's called Brahman. It's not space dependent, it's not time dependent. 10,000 years back also, same I was there. That's why spiritual teachings, 10,000 or 100,000 years are over, the spiritual teaching is the same. The method of teaching is changed, not the teaching.
So, also there is nothing like bigger I and me being part of that bigger I.
Now, how many eyes you have, sir? When you said 13 years back, you said in Bombay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now you are saying in Bangalore. How many eyes you have? Huh? There's only one eye. But confusion is the eye. Confusion is the transaction.
Right.
Right. See, for example, I'll give some example. Okay. A person, let's say a king. Okay. When he goes to the palace, when he goes to the house, he becomes the husband. When he goes to the palace, he becomes the king. When he plays with the children, he becomes the father. So how many names are there? Husband, father, king. How many persons are there? The roles are many, but essence. So millions and millions and billions of human beings are all only one I. That's called Atma, Paramatma. The transaction roles are different. Operational instruments are different. So don't confuse the transaction with the absolute. Absolute is only one and that's you. Because you know it, that's why you say I. And this is the meaning of Aham Brahmasmi. I am Brahman. I am consciousness. Are you clear? There may be millions of people, billions of living beings. All are just instruments, embodiment complexes. Each of them doing some role and play. The role and play keeps on changing. Today you become husband here, to mother, son. The roles will change. But I never changes. That I is Paramatma. I is God, which is you. Why are you confusing with your role with the reality? The role is unreal because it keeps changing. Unreal, definition of unreal is keeps changing. The reality is never changes. Now you know the reality. Why are you not going back to the reality again and again instead of going to changing reality?
If I become egoistic, if I become egoistic.
No, we are not speaking of ego and all, nothing. Yeah, see, for me, ego is a role. Sir, you are a husband.
Because I is Paramatma.
No, don't confuse that. Don't confuse that. Don't this ego terminology and all, old. They are all outdated. So, were you there 10 years back? Are you there? Were you there? Which city were there? 20 years back, 30 years back. Where were you?
Wherever he was.
Wherever you are. So that's I. Now you are here. I has changed. Has I changed? Has you changed? The I is same. But your role has changed. That time you are working, now you are retired. The role has changed doesn't mean that I has changed. So we confuse that changing role with the unchanging I. Okay? That confusion has to be removed. So this terminal spirituality has confused the ego and all those terminals brought in. The reality is I is unchanging. That is the principle. That unchanging I is common to all. It doesn't change with the person. Okay? And that's why it's called God. And the God is closer to you than anybody else on the earth. So I want to find God. Where do you find God? Where is within you? This body is changing, which is transactional, which is changing. Within the changing, where do you find the changing? The changing is within unchanging. The I is there everywhere. I is there here, I is there everywhere. Sorry.
So what is the Sanskrit word for consciousness?
Chaitanyam. Chit.
Chit.
Chit. Chit. Pradnanam. Other words. Okay. So, now we came to two things. Every object in the world is pointing to consciousness. And the word called I is also pointing to consciousness. Right? There are only two things. Subject and object. I am experiencing. And the experience object is there. The subject is consciousness, object is consciousness. Who is experiencing what? So our problem in life is because we think there is a separation because of a transactional reality. Because of the vyavaharika reality, we think there is a separation. Because of pratibhasika reality or mental reality, we think there is a separation. In reality, there never was a separation. You. Don't you have to say one?
Yeah.
Everything is I. Not the body I. The I which is unchanging me. And that I is my I. So what is the fear for me when I am the consciousness which is unchanging? There's nobody other than me. When you are speaking, I is speaking to I. So that is, the moment you understand the absolute reality, the duality collapses. The moment duality collapses, there's peace, because duality gives stress. I see the other, there's a stress. But I see myself in you, there's love, there's no stress, peace. Transactional reality becomes love, not stress. Your enemy comes, you know the same I is coming. So there's no fear. So this is the real meaning of unreal to real. From unreal is called mithya, real is called satya. And there's one more reality called false, which doesn't exist. We are not bothered about it. Real never changes. Unreal appears to be there, changing reality. False is never there. For example, egg of an elephant. It never is there. So we are not even bothered about false. We are not even bothered about truth. We are only bothered about mithya, because that's what is confusing us. As parama vyavaharika and pratibhasika reality. The confusion has to be removed through clear teaching. That is what is called spirituality. Okay? So we will close with the shloka. Purnamadam, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnamuduchyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnameva avashishyate. Om Shanti
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 Lokaha Samastaha Sukino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukino Bhavantu Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. All that is there is consciousness. Purnamadam means the consciousness is fullness. There's no deficiency there. Purnamidam means the world which I see is manifestation of consciousness. So remove the name and form, because name and form is only changing. The unchanging reality is consciousness, which is me, you and everything. Then where is the conflict? Where is the stress? There is peace alone. What is this, sir? Huh? Do you read newspaper?
I stopped reading quite sometimes.
Anybody need to read newspaper here?
Yeah.
Huh? You read newspaper. So he reads newspaper. Actually, I asked the question, read the newspaper. Go to the, not to the words, but the meaning. How do you read the paper, sir? You read the news in the paper. Okay?
News.
Huh?
News.
You read the news, but you don't read the paper.
No, from news. Subsequently, newspaper.
Newspaper is the word. But my question was, do you read newspaper? Paper. So you don't read the paper, you read the news. The paper is always there in the background. Are you getting me?
No, it is printed on the paper.
Huh? But your eyes are what? Attention is on what?
News.
Paper, you forget that it is there. As long as the light is there, we don't bother light is there. The moment light goes, we know light goes. Like that, paramarthika reality is there all the time, all the transaction, everywhere. Like paper. But your attention is on what? Vyavaharika. You understand? Paramarthika reality is the only thing which is easy in the world. On yourself. That's like paper. It's a background, everywhere is there. But your attention is focused on the news, because you want spicy news, no? Huh? The transaction is about spiciness. So why are you not looking at the absolute reality which is there in every transaction, everywhere? Okay? So your attention has to shift from Vyavaharika to Paramarthika. But depending on the Vyavaharika, go to Vyavaharika. Okay? So like, yes.
So, in these 2 hours, I understood something.
Uh-huh.
Now after going out, I'll, over a period of time, it evaporates.
Right.
And I'll forget about the consciousness.
Correct.
So,
see, you have to go back to your guru or master. This is not a one-time affair. Okay. So you need to continue your study until you are establishing the truth. See, this is a lecture. In lecture only can indicate the truth. But for any realization, you need to have a realized master work under his guidance. So if you are evolved enough, this much lecture is sufficient for you. But many people require more hand-holding support. So they have to work with the spiritual master and live in the truth until it's like somebody has to handhold you. You are stable there. Clear? So now last, finally we'll come to, okay? So this is a newspaper, right? What is this? What happened to rocket paper? The name and form, we are making us forget the paper. The Paramatma is there in every object, every transaction that it's visible as Paramatma reality. The name and form is confusing us. Learn to go back to the absolute reality once in a while, often, so that you will become peaceful. That's the fine. That is the meaning of Purnamada, Purnamidam. The subject-object duality, when it collapses, then you will feel fullness, purnatva, infinity. So that's your nature, that's what you are.